Hello, and welcome to another episode. In this episode, we're going to discuss how to observe an eclipsing binary star. An eclipsing binary is where a dimmer star in a multi-star system passes in front of its brighter counterpart. One of the easiest ways to observe this is to find the star Algol, which is actually a triple star system, but consists of one main bright star and another dimmer star that passes in front of it from our perspective. Well, I'm going to show you how to capture an eclipse of Algol, and what I captured myself. I thought this animation from the Shara interferometer shows nicely how an eclipsing binary actually occurs. As you can see from our perspective, the dimmer star covers up the brighter star, and once this occurs, it causes it to dim. This dimming occurs every 2 days, 20 hours, and 48.8 minutes. The change in magnitude can be from plus 2 to plus 3.3, and with magnitude, the larger the number, the dimmer it actually is. To find Algol, you must first find the Perseus constellation. To do this, find the bright signpost constellation Cassiopeia, and then draw an imaginary line down from Gamma Cassiopeia down to the star Rubac. Once you are in the Perseus constellation, follow the stars down through the Perseus constellation, one by one, until you reach the star Algol. Observing an eclipse of Algol is a good target for autumn, winter and spring skies, even when the full moon is out in force. To see when an eclipse of Algol occurs, just use the link to the Algol eclipse calculator detailed in the description below. Well, what can you see? Algol is one of those astronomical targets that need to be observed over an extended period of time. The whole process from maxima, which is the brightest point, to minima, which is the dimmest point, and back again will take about 10 hours. However, there is a noticeable difference 2 hours before or after the minima. So even if you've got a short amount of observing time, you can compare the difference in brightness from 2 hours before or after that point. I would also recommend recording the brightness of Algol the night before and then comparing it to the actual minima, because as you can see in this chart, the brightness does change over an extended period, so it would be good to make sure you're actually, if you're possible, that you get it when it's at its peak as well as at its minimum. I did something similar for this video. I started recording 2.5 hours before the minima, and then I carried on recording until 4.5 hours after the minima, taking a photo every 15 minutes. I would have recorded for longer, but unfortunately, bad weather started coming across and that stopped my recording. I then went out and recorded Algol the following night using exactly the same settings on my camera. I then combined all of those images together to show this sequence of images you're looking at now. And I think it really is quite striking how the brightness of Algol changes over that time period. But perhaps to make it even more obvious, here is a stacked image of both the maxima and the minima put side by side. And as you can see, there really is a difference in brightness there. There is actually quite a lot of history to Algol. In ancient times, ancient astronomers used to find Algol quite unnerving. So much so that the name Algol actually means the demon's head, and it's supposed to represent the Gorgon from ancient Greek myths in the constellation Perseus. I believe Perseus killed the Gorgon, but don't quote me on that. And in many cultures, it has actually got a bit of a bad reputation with links to bloody violence, but not entirely sure why. I guess a bit suspicious of the changing brightness. It stands out quite a bit compared to all the other stars. Well, that's it for this episode. If you like the video, then please give us a like. If you've got any questions about eclipsing binaries or Algol, then please do leave a comment below. And if you'd like to see more astronomy videos, then please do subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.